Kaiser Health Builder, Frequently Asked Questions. Hello everyone, this is Roan Celis Capistrano of 1 Million Club. Nakakatuwa na dumarami na ang Pinoy na natututong mag-ipon at mag-invest. Marami ng Pinoy ang nagsimula sa Kaiser at marami rin ang nagtatanong tungkol dito. Kaya naman in this video, I hope masagot ang lahat or majority ng tanong nyo. Question, ano ba ang Kaiser? Di ko maintindihan. Ang Kaiser ay 3-in-1 product, health insurance, life insurance, and investments. Bago mo panoorin ang video na to, please watch first my 17-minute video about Kaiser. I put the video link below. Question, stable ba ang Kaiser? Paano ako makakasiguro dyan? Paano pag nagsara ang Kaiser? Totoo ba yan? Lahat naman may risk. Lahat ng company pwedeng malugi at magsara. Ang titignan mo lang kung saan nag-i-invest ang Kaiser. Sa top corporations nag-i-invest ang Kaiser. Naka-diversify ang fund. Meron sa real estate, meron sa telecom, meron sa bank at iba pang industries. Di naman siguro sabay-sabay babagsak ang top corporations. Question, paano kung di ako makabayad? Paano kung mawalan ako ng trabaho at di ko na matuloy ang pagbabayad? Magkano makukuha ko pag di ko natuloy? Kung di ka makabayad on due date, you still have 60 days grace period from due date. Meaning, if nakabayad ka within grace period, walang penalty. Halimbawa, due date mo is July 1, 2017. So, meron ka pang until August 29 para makabayad. Kung di ka pa rin makabayad within grace period, you can reinstate your plan. Dalawa options mo to reinstate or activate your plan. Para di naman sayang ang binayad mo. First option is update. Member will pay the premiums due on all the missed months plus surcharge of 1.5% per month or 18% per annum from the date of each unpaid installment. And second option is redate. Member will only pay the premium for the month but the maturity date will be moved. Halimbawa, may client ako na di nakabayad ng 3 months. Gusto niya yung option 1, yung update. So, kailangan niyang bayaran pati yung surcharge na 2,255.63 and reinstatement fee of 300 pesos in addition sa total premium. Sa case na to, isang semi-annual premium lang naman di niya nabayaran. Pero kung tatlong semi-annual premium din mo nabayaran, kailangan mong bayaran lahat ng unpaid premiums mo. Ano naman difference ng computation sa option 2, which is redate? Isang premium lang need mong bayaran, walang surcharge, and of course, magbabayad ka din ng 300 pesos reinstatement fee. Ang pagkakaiba, walang surcharge pero iuurong yung maturity date ng policy mo. Kaya ang tawag ay redate. Kaya importante na bayaran mo on time ang Kaiser plan kasi may mga disadvantage pag late payment. Ito yung mga requirements when you reinstate your plan. Reinstatement application form, reinstatement fee of 300 pesos. In addition, reinstatement can be done within 2 years of the first unpaid due date. Halimbawa, kung July 1, 2017 first unpaid due date mo, meron ka pa until June 30, 2019 to reinstate or activate your plan. The member shall be considered a new applicant subject to pre-existing conditions and for purposes of contestability of insurance coverage and to any other requirements for a new applicant for membership in effect at that time. Ito na nga yung sinasabi kong disadvantage. Kaiser will cancel the contract without need of notice to the owner if he fails to reinstate within the prescribed period. All reinstated plans shall be subjected to the new price. Meron akong client na nasubject sa new price. Mas mataas na yung premium na kailangan niyang bayaran. Please email support at kaiserhealthgroup.com for assistance to reinstatement, especially kung update ang gagawin. Ako nag-i-email ako sa support para magpa-compute ng total na babayaran. Just email the information like policy details and target date kung kailan mo planong magbayad. And for the last question na, magkano makukuha ko pag di ko natuloy? Cash value surrender. The owner may surrender the contract for its cash value stated in the schedule of benefits provided the plan is active for at least a year. Yes, may makukuha ka kung at least nakabayad ka ng isang taon. Pwedeng after 4 years na nakapaghulog ka, 20% lang ang makukuha mo sa total na nabayad mo. So we recommend na ituloy na lang ang plan or pwede din namang i-transfer sa iba para ibang tao na magtuloy. Internal arrangement nyo na lang kung paano ka babayaran ng new plan holder para sa mga nabayad mo na. Transfer, the owner is allowed to transfer his rights under his contract at any time. Requirements, written request, membership application signed by the transferee, payment of processing fee. Question, insurance company ba ang Kaiser? No, Kaiser is a health maintenance organization, HMO company, duly accredited with the Department of Health, Bureau of Health Facilities and Services. This company is likewise registered with the SEC on June 8, 2004 as a healthcare provider with an authorized capital stock of 160 million. Question, covered ba pati family ko? No, ang Kaiser long term ay individual plan. Kaya kung ikaw ang Kaiser plan holder, ikaw lang ang covered. Sa short term healthcare ganun din. Hindi covered ang family unless kumuha ka ng family package. Walang HMO na nagko-cover ng buong pamilya na para sa isang member lang ang binayaran. Pero ang maganda sa Kaiser, may family assistance service. Pwede mong ipa-approve sa Kaiser management kung pwedeng i-extend sa immediate family mo ang Kaiser card mo. Ito yung mga requirements. Family assistance service. Policy should be in active status and plan should have completed at least 1 year payment. Nominated patient must be an immediate family member of the policyholder or within the first degree of consanguinity. Policyholder agrees to avail only of the services of Kaiser's accredited doctors and affiliated network of hospitals. Assistance to be provided by Kaiser shall only be to the extent of the allowable benefits due to the plan holder under his policy. Prior to discharge of the nominated patient, payment should have been settled with Kaiser. If plan holder requested or opted to pay on a term basis, payment scheme is on case-to-case basis and subject to Kaiser approval. Please note that this assistance is an accommodation and not considered a benefit of the plan, hence approval and denial on the availment solely depends on the Kaiser management evaluation. Question, pwede bang mag-withdraw? Pwede ba mag-loan? During 20-year term, di ka pwede mag-withdraw pero pwede mong magamit ang Kaiser fund mo sa healthcare-related expenses mo. Pwede kang mag-withdraw on or after maturity date. After 20 years, kung di mo withdrawin lahat yung maturity value, may 10% interest per year ang fund mo. And yes, pwedeng mag-loan sa Kaiser. Just email support@kaiserhealthgroup.com for requirements. Interest rate is 1.5% per month or 18% per annum. Question, pwede ba akong kumuha ng Kaiser kahit nasa ibang bansa ako? Yes. Maraming plan holder na OFW. You can fill up and sign Kaiser form online. If you want to avail Kaiser, you can email me at roancelis@gmail.com. Please indicate in the subject Kaiser proposal. Question, 56 years old na ako. Pwede pa ba ako sa Kaiser? Yung 3 years old na anak ko, pwede ba sa Kaiser? Yes, pwede pa ang 56 years old. Eligible is 10 to 60 years old. Kung 3 years old pa lang ang anak mo, pwedeng ikaw muna ang kumuha ng Kaiser. I-transfer mo na lang sa anak mo ang plan pag 10 years old na siya. Question, pwede ba ako mag-change ng mode of payment? Halimbawa, monthly to annual? Yes, pwede mag-upgrade ng mode of payment. For your information, ang options mo ay spot cash or one-time payment, monthly, quarterly, semi-annual, or annual. Kaya if you want to change your mode of payment from monthly to annual, pwede. Ang tawag doon, amendment of mode of payment. Ang di allowed ay downgrade like annual to monthly. Mode of payment can be upgraded anytime after completion of its respective cycle. If within 30 days after purchase, requirements are filled out amendment form, payment of additional installment due corresponding to the amount of the updated mode of payment. If beyond 30 days after purchase, requirements are filled out amendment form, processing fee of 300 pesos, computation of dues based on the desired mode of payment. You may request computation from Kaiser, email support@kaiserhealthgroup.com. Question, pwede ba ako magpa-change ng plan type? Yes, pwede kang magpa-change ng plan type within 30 days only from effectivity date of your plan. Pwede lang din upgrade ng plan type like from K75 to K100. Di allowed ang downgrade ng plan type like from K100 to K75. Again, plan can be upgraded within 30 days after its effectivity date. Requirements, filled out amendment form, processing fee of 300 pesos, payment of additional installment corresponding to the updated plan. Question, kailangan ko ba magpa-member sa IMG kung kukuha ako ng Kaiser? No, you are not required to become an IMG member to get Kaiser plan. But I highly recommend that you register also as an IMG member dahil sa mga benefits like financial education and financial checkup. To know more about IMG, please watch my 17-minute video. Please check the link below. Question, covered po ba dyan consultation? During the paying period, no. Outpatient benefit like consultation is not covered. Only inpatient benefit is covered during the first 7 years. After 7 years paying period, yes, covered na ang consultation. Inpatient, outpatient, and even maternity benefits covered na after 7 years. Limit is based on your fund balance. Question, ano difference niyan sa short-term healthcare? Kaiser Ultimate is a long-term healthcare. To understand the difference of long-term healthcare versus short-term healthcare, please watch my video about this. Please check the link below for detailed explanation. Question, paano kung magkasakit ako during 7-year paying period? You can use the inpatient benefits. Kung need mo ma-confine sa hospital, pwede mong magamit ang Kaiser based on your annual benefit limit. The higher the plan, the higher the annual benefit limit. Pag nagamit mo ang Kaiser during 7 years, mawawala ang bonus. Bonus, you are entitled to receive bonus on maturity date if no availment was made during the 7-year paying period. Question, may makukuha ba ako after 7 years? Wala, unless gusto mo isurrender ang policy mo. Claim will be based on cash value schedule indicated in your contract. Question, saan ako magbabayad? You can pay your first payment to any IMG's bank account. You can pay online or manual. IMG, or International Marketing Group, is the exclusive broker of Kaiser International Health Group Incorporated. Here are IMG's bank account. You can pay your subsequent payment to any IMG's bank account or directly to any Kaiser International Health Group Inc.'s bank account. Question, meron ba akong makukuhang card? None. After verification of your first payment, wait for 1 to 2 weeks approval of your application to Kaiser. Once approved, Kaiser will email you your access to Kaiser's Online Policy Management System or OPMS. In OPMS, you can view your contract, benefit card, history of payment, and scanned copy of your official receipts. If you want to have hard copy of benefit card and policy, you can download this in OPMS and print. If you want to request hard copy of health card, benefit card, contract and accredited clinics and hospitals book, you have to pay 800 pesos. This hard copy is good for 1 year. Once fully paid ka na sa Kaiser or after 7 years, you can fill up Visa card application para magawan ka ng Kaiser Visa card. This Visa card is free. Question, insured ba ako dyan? Yes, may life insurance ka for 20 years or until 65 years old, whichever is applicable. Philam Life ang kapartner ni Kaiser when it comes to life insurance. May health insurance ka din for 20 years. At kapag di mo kinuha lahat ng maturity value mo on the maturity date, you still have health insurance based on your fund balance. Pwede ko ba magamit Kaiser outside the Philippines? No, you can avail healthcare benefits here in the Philippines sa mga accredited doctors, hospitals, and clinics. Lahat naman ng health card sa Pilipinas, dito mo lang din sa Pilipinas pwede i-avail ang health benefits. So if you are an OFW, consider Kaiser as your retirement fund instead of health card kung madalas kang nasa abroad at matagal ka pa sa abroad. Paano kung 61 years old na ako? Di ka na pwede sa Kaiser long-term healthcare, pero you can avail senior care. This short-term healthcare is for 61 to 100 years old. Paano kung maliit lang budget ko? You can avail daily health plan. This is a short-term healthcare na pwedeng magamit for inpatient cases. We have plan 1,000 and plan 2,000. For a minimum of 1,000 annual premium, meron ka ng health insurance. Question, paano kung sakitin ako? Ano dapat kunin ko? We suggest that both short-term and long-term healthcare kunin mo. Yung short-term, magagamit mo today. And ang long-term healthcare naman, magandang isabay kasi at least when you get old, may healthcare fund ka na. Ang traditional health card kasi covers up to age 60 lang. Ang Kaiser long term magagamit mo kahit beyond 60 years old ka na, basta may fund ka pa. Question, meron din bang short-term healthcare ang Kaiser? Yes, aside sa na-mention ko na senior care and daily health plan, we have plan for individual, family, mini-group, group, and corporate.